me then. I fixed the blurriness on this camera. Automatic light, whatever stuff, is just a bad idea. Just a bad idea. Automatic brightness balance or some nonsense like that. That's never any good anyway. Alright, there's nobody on that sim in the area here, so we may as well hide that. We're just waiting for all the passengers to get aboard on our continuation of our flight to the Hungarian Grand Prix. So we're on our way to Budapest. We had to divert over here to Nuremberg. And we're sitting here at gate number 10. Just going to go through our checklist. Get things fired up here. Track IR is working today. I don't know what was wrong with it yesterday. Something, obviously, but it was not the game, not the sim's fault. That's just some weird stuff, I guess. Nav lights, cockpit lighting, yeah, we don't really need any. It is nice and bright. Beacon. Oh, I did forget one thing. I thought I almost remembered everything today. Almost. Very close. Get some stats on the top of the stream there. There we go. All right, let's get the APU fired up. Maybe we do want a little bit of... I keep forgetting that these displays are tied to that. APU flap is open! And APU is spooling up. Hope everybody's had a good first half of the week so far. APU available. We can disconnect external power. We are powered by ourselves now, so that is excellent.
Cockpit to ground. Go ahead, flight deck. We will be ready shortly. Roger.
Oh, look at the textures of dust and fingerprints on the MCDU here. I don't know if I've noticed that before. That might actually be one of the reasonably new things that they've added. It's very cool, especially with the light coming in like this. Get our weather. Get everything loaded and balanced here. We'll print that. Load up our flight plan. Oh, we'll just set our zero fuel weight and block fuel. There we go. Mm-hmm. Let's have a quick look at what departure we are flying. We're taking off on runway 10. We're using the Rody 4. Mike. And there is no transition. Get that inserted. And we will eventually use the, what are we flying into? ILS 31 right. The Annex 2 Tango arrival and the Atico. It's not showing up here. Oh, I got the wrong star. It is the... How did it get the wrong runway even? Did I click all the wrong buttons? I did. 31, right. Annex 2 Hotel with the Atico approach. There we go. Excellent. Let's have a quick look. Switch to plan mode. Our departure is like straight out. Yep, and we just do this little hook. That all looks good. And one final thing. Let's get our performance configured here. It should all be LBA flaps one takeoff. Get our V-speeds in. A little bit lighter than last time because we are not flying quite as far, so we've got a bit less fuel on board. Do I have any sort of transition altitude? 5,000. Excellent. All right. That is our before taxi checklist is complete. We're getting ready to start the engines now and get pushback. Fuel pumps, ignition switch. And let's have a quick look at where we are. Runway 10, which is to our right. So we will push back and turn to our left.
Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead, flight deck.
We are ready for pushback and engine start.
Roger, release the parking brakes, please.
Parking brakes released.
Pushing back.
No buildings behind us or anything. That's good.
You are clear behind, and you can start your engines at your discretion.
All right, we'll fire up the right engine.
Pushback complete. Set parking brakes, please.
Parking brakes set.
Roger. Okay, the tow bar is disconnected and the equipment is clear. We will see you on the left side with the pin.
Thanks, and you can disconnect and go to hand signals.
Thanks. Have a good flight. See you later.
Start up. Engine number two, or engine number one, rather. I do love the sound of that engine spinning up. All right. Shut off the APU. The taxi lights on. Flaps one. Ground spoilers armed. Auto brake max, and we are good to go, taxi. Almost, anyways. We should turn on our transpondery stuff. Here we go. We got the iPad, the fly pad up at some point here. We don't really need it. There's one thing we need to look at is what our altitude is going to be and speed. I know it's 250. Are there any altitude restrictions? We fly straight out 6,000. We'll do 6,000 initially. And then I'm guessing our cruise altitude, I haven't checked it, but I'm assuming it's going to be flight level 350. We'll see. This time I've got the weather not set to live weather, but rather to a preset, because it seems like the live weather is a little bit glitchy at the moment. Which is too bad.
Flight attendants, please prepare for takeoff.
Strobes. Taxi lights off, landing lights on. I like to have the terrain on takeoff. Takeoff config is okay. We are all ready to go. Feet. So we'll go to first, and we are all set to go. And it's stable. And away we go. Over to the autopilot. Ground spoilers disarmed. I do not see any actual flight level restrictions there, so we'll go up to our cruise altitude. Okay. Flaps up. And we've already reached our transition altitude, so over to standard barometer, standard altimeter. Nice views. Alright, that's 10,000. Landing lights come off. Seatbelt signs come off. Doesn't look like we've got any clouds to go through here. Because I put it on the few clouds preset. We are looking good. What did the MCDU expect for cruise altitude? Doesn't say.
Aha.
Oh, I can switch my maps around from one side to the other. Cool. That means that at some points I can just kind of, turn my instrument camera off, because a lot of times I'm not actually doing much during the flight. But then I can move the map over to the other side, which is a little more interesting of a side to look at. With the weather preset, it definitely has no issues climbing. So there's something in the live weather that's just giving it problems somehow. It's too bad. I quite enjoy usually flying with live weather, but it is what it is. Just had a quick peek at the Simbrief flight plan, and we're actually supposed to be cruising at flight level 330, so I just changed that. Alright, we're coming up on our top of descent here. I kind of roughly aimed it at about 38 miles to Annexa, which is right there. We're about 40 now, 39, so let's go and I'll dial in 4,000 feet. And we'll see how it takes us down. Gonna get a nice view of Budapest as we fly past it here. I don't know why the line on the navigation display there has turned really weird and crazy. So now we are slowing down to 250 because we're getting to 10,000 feet. Which also means landing lights and seat belts. Nice view. There's the airport. You see the two runways. We'll be landing on 31 right, so the far side one. Looking pretty good. No clouds in the way of the airport, really. Maybe a couple in the way, but nothing too bad. Really should at some point hook this up to the charts, because this has Navigraph chart integration now, which is cool. But I don't really need it because I have it on my iPad. It's great for VR though. Then again, the Airbus doesn't really lend itself to VR because it's just too flights are typically too long for VR, you know. Fine. I shouldn't have done that yet. We could get down to 4,000, really, before we slow down too much more here, but that's all right. Yeah, there's like no terrain around us here. I mean, it's pretty obvious, pretty flat. That's kind of a nice view. Let's see, is this going to... Yeah. So it does respect this. I gotta try this. So I've set it to 3,000 for the altitude, because that's our next waypoint. But there is a 4,000 feet constraint at this next waypoint, so it should keep that. And... And I imagine it is going to... I want to see if it's going to descend us after. If it's going to hit this at 4,000 and then continue descending down to 3,000, which is really what I've asked it for. In fact, I'm going to take it a step further and set it to 2,500, which is our capture path for the... capture altitude for the glide slope. So let's see how smart this is, because this is new. I have not played with this yet in the fly-by-wire mod. It's part of their... it's a new thing on their autopilot. It's sort of like VNAV, I guess. Okay, yeah, it's switched over to 3,000. So it does, it is aware, and we're like right on the waypoint at 4,000. That's excellent. Well done there. See the lights from the runways. A nice clear sight of it. It's managing this amazingly well, descending us just ever so slightly, slowing us down. Amazing. Altitude constraint, it says, right there in the green. Very cool. It's going to screw up the engines just a bit to maintain our speed here, as we're going to fly at 3,000 for just a few moments here before this is going to switch. So altitude constraint. And it should change at some point once we get close enough that it's going to consider this constraint as having been met. It should then switch to 2,500, which is what I have programmed. There it is. It's awesome. So activate the approach mode. Shot that corner a little bit. I guess that's because it switched over to the localizer. But we're going to zigzag a bit here, huh? I should have actually waited until it settled to go straight before I switched over to approach, because the localizer seems to be... it's not quite as good as you can see here, as actually like lining itself up properly with the localizer. And I hope that's not going to make us miss our altitude too much here. We are going pretty slow though, so. Now get down, get down, get down. Just told it to expedite. 2,500. Maybe not expedite. Let's apply some speed brake to help her out. That should have helped. There's the glide slope. don't know why the cabin thing does not always. Sure, what the deal is with that?
Flight attendants, please prepare for landing.
I suspect we'll be able to auto land here, but gotta be prepared just in case we're not. Is engaged, is armed. We should be good.
200.
There we have it. I don't know why we're suddenly stuck here. This is weird. What's happening? Okay, there we go. That was just bizarre. Looks like the big terminal stuff is over there, but we can't make this turn here, so we'll have to taxi down there. Another broken livery. I gotta find out which one that is. It's only when we get closer. Before that, it's fine. I guess it has a different one showing up. There are some gates. We'll park ourselves right next to that Ryanair here. Oh, there's a little guy there. That's inappropriate. You don't belong there, buddy. This is a parking spot for the big boys. Anyways, we'll get her parked up here. Seems like a good place to call it a night. Oh, that's an interesting camera angle. Why are we moving? That was weird. But we can get a nice screenshot here, and I think we'll go and can't connect them. All right. Well, in any case, I can certainly get the engines shut off here and get ourselves all parked away nice and quiet. So, hope you enjoyed the flight. Looking forward to the next one. I'm not sure what the next Grand Prix is, but be sure to check out my Rams tour as well if you like seeing the... Sorry, I haven't flown the CJ4 yet in Sim Update 5, so we'll see how that goes. Anyways, till next time, see ya.